seated. Day for me, or not a great day, but emotional day for me, was when we were putting up all those signs of your senior pictures. You can see them right now. And I found myself thinking about what each one of you did and meant to me, and they're meant to our community. As I walk into your class, I see like all the great things you do, and it was really emotional. I didn't expect it to be emotional, much as today has been moments of emotional kind of feelings. I've watched you all grow into incredible young people sitting before me today, and the hardest part of the school closure was not seeing you every day and being a part of your lives as much, and it's so lucky to be here today. And your class has truly been put to the test, and as Oprah said in her graduation speech, you are the chosen class. I usually start my speeches by showcasing the highlights, and I got to start with a little bit of the shadows. And when you were born, you know, there's the terrorist attacks on the Twin Towers, we've had enormous challenges along the way globally, thinking about global warming, school shootings, and the racial incidents that have occurred recently and in the past. We've all dealt with all of those, and you were the class that also was here that lost three beloved teachers in 4 years. It's been tough that way. Adversity's hit us all. And you're kind of at school. I don't know if you remember, we had homecoming, and just a little letdown was when we had storm coming. Remember storm coming? We had to cancel it. It's not my favorite day. I have a very vivid memory of that. And then you were there, and then we had the Veterans Day fire this year. We did Veterans Day all over again. Remember that? Somehow it seems like a long time ago we did that, but it wasn't that long ago. It was last fall. And you managed to survive school construction this year as well. We're going to have a great, beautiful school, and you rarely complain. You might have complained about parking a little bit, but you didn't complain much about construction. And let's not forget the last 3 months, how it's been. It's been a lot of moments of isolation when they should be the best moments of your high school career. You had to grow up incredibly fast, and you did it well. I feel closer to this group because of the way you handled all those things with so much courage, so much persistence, so much kindness for one another in the face of enormous loss, grief, and stress.
Next year, James plans to be a music major at a four-year school. His future career goals is to be a musician and studio technician. He wrote, "Dear music teachers, thank you for breaking the monotony of high school." James Glyden.